Miss Park and Resistance are guests. Quý vị có thể nhận thấy sở hữu những món đồ kinh đồ của Saigon.
Go, let's go. Thank you. here in Saigon, Vietnam. It's a beautiful, gorgeous Sunday afternoon. We're glad to have you on the live stream. I'm your commentator, Darren Joe, and I'm sure you're excited as I am for this contest between the fourth and fifth place teams in the ABL. The fourth place, Indonesia Warriors, with a 6-8 record, going up against the home team, Saigon Heat, with a 5-7 record. In their previous two meetings, the Saigon Heat have beaten the Indonesia Warriors both times, 72-61 and 72-56. So far this year, the Saigon Heat have had the Indonesia Warriors number. However, after the Indonesia Warriors started the season 1-4, they've been coming on strong, and they've beaten all the top teams in the AirAsia ABL, including High Tech Bangkok City, the Malaysia Dragons, and the Singapore Slingers. So they're a very dangerous team, and they're going to be looking to get revenge on the Saigon Heat. You'll notice that two of the main starters for the Indonesia Warriors are not here today, Arki Wisnu and Vintan Nolan, not in the lineup for this game against the Heat. So the Warriors bench players are going to have to really step up and help Tremaine Johnson and John Smith score the ball. As you see, the starting lineup, new import, Michael Fay will be starting at center, Tremaine Johnson and Christian Satepu at forwards, and Lakudu and Sirigar in the backcourt. Tremaine Johnson is the Indonesia Warriors' leading scorer, seventh in the league with 18.2 points per game. So Saigon Heat really need to focus their attention on him and make sure to shut him down. A very important game for both squads. We're past the midpoint way of this season, and the Heat have 8 games left. The Warriors have 6 games left. These two teams will face each other 2 more times, and as they are number 4 and number 5 in the AirAsia League, this is critical for the Saigon Heat to win both of these games against the Warriors and make up space in the rankings. Coach Rabideau has got to motivate his troops and coach them down the stretch, as we see the starting lineup. Justin Williams having a monster season this year, starting at center, with Dustin Scott and Leo Avenido at the forward positions, Viet Arnold and point guard Floyd Baguion in the backcourt. Our officials for this game are Oh Xiong Chan, Ferdinand Pascal, and Po Seng Go. Now for each nation's national anthem.
First of all, it's the Indonesia anthem.
And it's game on here at CIS Arena. These two teams, it's going to be a fierce battle. What are the keys to today's game? For the Indonesia Warriors, who is going to neutralize Justin Williams, the man on your screen right now? In the past two games against the Indonesia Warriors, Justin Williams has averaged 24 points per game and 20 rebounds. He's absolutely dominated the Indonesia Warriors on the inside. However, the Warriors have just signed Michael Fay, the 7-footer from UCLA, who's played professionally all over the world, China, Poland, UAE, Japan, and even for the D-League for the Los Angeles Lakers. He's a big guy, he plays tough defense, so he will do his best to neutralize Justin Williams. The other key for the Warriors is to really move the ball and make their shots. They're heavily reliant on the three-point shot and one-on-one moves. And they're without two of their best offensive players, Arki Wisnu and Vinton Nolan, this game. So who's gonna step up and help Tremaine Johnson with the scoring load? Is it gonna be Gunawan? Is it gonna be John Smith Jr., Lekudu, Sitepu? Who's gonna step up and give the Warriors enough firepower to get over the hump against a high-scoring Saigon Heat team? Keys of the game for the Saigon Heat. Rebounds. If they can limit the number of second chance opportunities for the Indonesia Warriors, they're going to be in good shape. Their starting five averages 73 points per game. It's the most potent offense in terms of starting five in the league. So if they can rebound and play solid defense, they have a really good shot of winning this game. Also, can they execute down the stretch? This has been the Saigon Heat's Achilles heel against every team in the AirAsia ABL, including the number one and two ranked High Tech Bangkok City and Malaysia Dragons. They have had leads going into the fourth period, but have lost those games. In fact, three of the last four games, the Saigon Heat have lost by less than 4 points. So key for the Heat, this game, can they execute down the stretch against this tough Indonesia Warriors team? The Warriors will try to wear down the Heat with their deep bench. The Heat, very reliant on their starting five, like I said, averaging 73 points per game, but also over 35 minutes per game. So they're getting less than 5 minutes of rest. Can the Warriors wear out the Heat? Starting for the Saigon Heat, we have Justin Williams, Dustin Scott, Froy Baggion, Viet Arnold, and Leo Avenido, the three-point marksman. And in for the Warriors, we see Michael Fay, who is actually taller than Justin Williams, ready to take the jump ball. Dodo Sitepu, Sirigar, Lekudu, and Tremaine Johnson, the team's leading scorer. Heat gained possession. Ooh, and Baggion looked like he got away with the travel there. Heat set up their offense. Scott, open from the top of the mountain. Short on the three. Fay gathers his first rebound, second game in the ABL. Fay, nice inbounds pass to Sitepu, misses the bunny. Williams, averaging 20 rebounds against the Warriors, collects his first. Arnold, step back. Too strong. It'll be Saigon Heat ball. So both teams, a little cold to start this game, missing the first three shots. The Saigon Heat, in their homestand, this is the fourth of four consecutive games at home. have started out the first quarter strong in all four games. Let's see if they can continue that streak here. What a crossover from the musician! And his layup rims in and out. So four misses in a row for both teams. No look pass from Lakudu to Surigar. It'll be Heat ball. Good defense there from Leo Avenido. Another sold-out game here at CIS Arena. Heat fans, the most loyal in the league, proudly wearing their red. It looks like Coach Rabideau's electing to go with the pick and roll with Roy Baggion. Scott tiptoes on the baseline, doesn't make it through, so he's called for the out-of-bounds. Still scoreless with 8 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in the first period. What a matchup, Mike Fay and Justin Williams. Johnson from way downtown, air ball. And I think both teams understand how important this game is. We're seeing some nerves early in this first period. Tremaine Johnson is only shooting 31% from the field this year. And another miss from Avenido. Ooh, Lakudu, sloppy ball handling. Satepu, bigger than Avenido. Covers the ball, baseline J. No good, and the Heat do a good job of boxing out. Baggio to Williams, fouled, no good. So Roy Baggio, one of the best, if not the best, pick and roll point guard in the AirAsia ABL, setting his teammate Justin Williams up perfectly. Justin Williams is shooting 38% from the stripe this year. Has been the Heat's defensive anchor, averaging 5 blocks a game to go along with 17 rebounds and 18 points a game. So he is their anchor in the paint and makes 1 out of 2. Low scoring affair here at CIS Arena so far. And the Warriors continue to pound it into Satepu. Satepu driving his shoulder to Avenido, and that's his second turnover. Williams, whoa, 360 move, rejected. Let's see what the Heat set up on this inbounds play. Screen for Avenido. He's open. He fires in and out. Williams misses the follow. We'll get a third chance. No. Thought he was fouled. No call from the refs. Tremaine Johnson, one-on-one moves. Taking Scott to the hole. Rejected. Gets it back between the legs. And we're going to get a foul call. Refs saying that Dustin Scott stuck out his leg. So that'll be Dustin Scott's first foul. Warriors gotta get the ball in time. Just barely beat the 5-second time limit. Lakudu, lefty southpaw to Fay. Nice reverse layup from Fay. Tiptoeing around Justin Williams to score. Michael Fay played his college ball at UCLA. Graduated there in 2006. He's traveled all around the world plying his trade. Scott, good defense from Johnson, forcing him left. Tough three-pointer, and he's way off the mark. Williams with another offensive rebound and is fouled. So Justin Williams' activity maybe a little too much there, and refs are saying that Williams there drove his shoulder into Fay. get him with the offensive foul. So the JD brothers, Justin and Dustin, each pick up one foul in consecutive possessions. Johnson from way downtown. No, and both teams are ice cold from the outside. Williams, sloppy handle. Avenido for three. Gets his rebound. Back into Williams. Easy layup. No offensive call that time. And Williams makes Faye pay for the flop. Just too easy for big man Williams. Oh, Avenido gambles. It pays off. He gets a steal. He takes it all the way. Nice finish over the taller Satepu. Great one-on-one moves from Avenida, and he's given his Saigon Heat a 5-2 lead. Warriors have only scored 2 points in 5 minutes here in the first period. Heat playing tough defense. Fay against Williams, just beats the buzzer and scores. So Fay has scored all 4 points for the Warriors, and he quiets this Saigon Heat crowd. Scott goes left, nowhere to go, finds Baggio, back to Scott. Nice finish. So great passing from the Heat. And the Warriors need to do a better job of contesting those shots in the paint. It's too easy for Scott and too easy for Williams. So Johnson's gonna try another three, misses again. So again, the Warriors, very reliant on their outside shooting. They're gonna have to make those. Scott has the space to work on Johnson. Comes up short. Good defense there from Johnson. Wow! 360 move from Johnson, and he hasn't made one shot to start this first period. Jermaine Johnson, ice cold so far. Backdoor cut, Avenido, intercepted. Okudu, pressing it. Johnson, blows the layup. Avenido's wide open for three, drills it. You can't give the best three-point shooter in the league that much room. He will make you pay every time. Avenido makes his 28th three-pointer this season, leading the league, and puts his team up 10-4. We'll be right back. Jermaine Johnson feeling the pressure and the burden to score for his team, taking a lot of shots, but so far he's gone 0-6 to start this first period, and the Warriors are shooting a woeful 20%. Perhaps the reason why Coach Kokorda of the Warriors has made his substitutions and brings in John Smith Jr. as well as number 14, Saragar. So, whoa, tough break there for the Heat. Jermaine Johnson went up strong, looked like he missed the layup. The refs call foul. And that is Dustin Scott's second foul. And of course, the Heat starters cannot afford to get into foul trouble. Johnson finally gets on the scoreboard with that free throw. So on offense, it's been all of Michael Fay and Tremaine Johnson, the Warriors' two international imports, doing all the scoring for the Warriors. Backdoor cut to Arnold, scores! Beautiful give and go, two-man game. Williams to Arnold. Great pass, better finish. Torres to Senegar. Whoa. And Senegar is way off the mark. I think he missed that one by about 5 feet. Senegar feeling the jitters. Williams on Fay. Fall away. No good. Nice rebound by John Smith. And great defense from Mike Fay. He's not giving Justin Williams any easy looks on those post-ups. Smith, this is his first chance. And here come the Heat. Up 12-6. Arnold, clear path to the basket. Rejected by Johnson. Wow, what a block. Michael Fay, all for the travel. One too many steps. So both teams struggling to put points on the board. That has been the story for the Warriors, as we see. Yep, that's one extra step there for Mike Fay. And Phan Tran Mun, the Heat's best local player, comes in and is tied up. So Mun has struggled recently in his past few games. The home crowd really pulling for their star local player to step up and contribute. Against the Malaysia Dragons, Mun came in and had two quick turnovers and was quickly put back on the bench by Coach Rabideau. So tough start there for Mun. Smith Jr. pulls the trigger, good. John Smith Jr., one of the Warriors' best three-point shooters, makes his 18th three-pointer of the season. So Heat have to close out on John Smith Jr. Nowhere to go for Williams. Great defense by the bigs of the Warriors. Smith Jr., will he get two in a row? No. Crossover, Scott. Stripped by Smith. Two on one break. Smith's going to go all the way. Rejected by Avenido. Woo! And Avenido might be 36, but he's still got the hops and the timing to send that ball flying. What a defensive play from Leo Avenido. Woo! Timed it perfectly. Offensive foul on number 16, John Smith Jr. With 50 seconds left in this first period, and it's been pretty ugly. Both teams struggling to put points on the board. Both teams playing great D. Ryan Lay has checked in for the Heat. And Arnold's open from the baseline. Nothing but the bottom of the net. In rhythm, Ben Arnold, Mr. Efficient for the Saigon Heat. Ben Arnold averaging close to 15 points a game for the Heat. It's been a great pickup for this team. Smith Jr., a lot of dribbling, nearly a turnover. No. And Senegar not aware of the shot clock, and that's a costly turnover for the Indonesia Warriors. If the Heat score here, they're going to have a nice cushion going into the second period. Arnold, one-on-one on Johnson. Gets a double screen, avoids it, takes it to the hole. No foul call. Williams with the follow, and he beats the buzzer. What activity from Justin Williams, and he continues to dominate the Indonesia Warriors. A lot of traffic there for Vian Arnold, but you can always count on Justin Williams to pick up the trash around the basket, and he finishes with the best of them in the ABL. So Williams has 5 points to finish that first quarter. And we'll be right back for second period action on the live stream. Far in this game, the Heat continued to have the Warriors' number, up 16-9. And the Warriors are shooting a dreadful 19% from the field, 3-for-16 from 2-point, and 1-for-6 from downtown. That's not going to be enough to beat the Heat. Indonesia Warriors have a much easier schedule to finish this fifth season of the ABL. They have 6 games left, and 3 of them are against last place Laskar Drea South Sumatra, and they're heavy favorites in those games. So the Heat, with 8 games left, have a much tougher schedule against High Tech Bangkok City, playing them twice, playing the Slingers twice, and playing the Malaysia Dragons once. Those are the top 3 teams in the ABL. So this is why this is such a critical game for the Heat to win, to stay competitive in the standings and make the playoffs. The Heat, to start this second period, have Bagion, Avenido, Ryan Lay, Dustin Scott, and Vian Arnold in the game. So Justin Williams getting some well-deserved rest to start this second period. Bagion goes to the baseline, finds Scott, called for the travel. And not much time, not much rest for Justin Williams as Avenido steps out. In for the Warriors, John Smith Jr., Gudawan, who's been shooting really well from the outside. Satoris, Tremaine Johnson, Gudawan. This is a 3. That's the commentator's curse for you, folks. So Gudawan misses his first attempt, but the Warriors are happy to have him shoot those open looks. Ooh, speaking of open looks, I think Bagion saw someone who wasn't there. So he can't believe it. I can't believe it either. Froy Bagion, second in the league in assists, averaging 5 a game. one of the best passers in the league. Not that time. Oh, Satoris stuffed by Williams, but Faye is in the right place, and he scores another easy layup. So Faye in the right place scores easily, and if the Warriors can continue to penetrate and draw Justin Williams away, that's a good way for them to put points on the board. Scott fouled. We see Kunawan has to foul the Butler harder than that. Dustin Scott shooting 62% from the stripe. Completes the three-point play and gives his Heat a comfortable 8-point lead. John Smith Jr., wow. Once a former Saigon Heat player, has made his rounds around the ABL. It's a wide open look for Faye, in and out. So Faye showing he's got a lot of game. Can take that step back 15 footer and is solid on the inside. Arnold, great look for him. Oh, nice no look pass. Smith Jr. to Johnson. What a dish. Fakes everyone out, and Johnson with the two-handed stuff. Heat trying to find Leo open in the corner. And Arnold, 2 seconds left. Offensive foul on Avenido. So we've had a lot of offensive fouls called here by the refs today. And as always, refs here in the booths from this crowd, never happy with the call against the Saigon Heat. Another great pass from Smith. Faye blows a layup. Ooh, Avenido looking to shoot. Bagion, much quicker than his defender, finds Scott in the corner. Way short, barely grazed the rim. Too much dribbling there from Smith. Should have given it up. Scott takes it to the hole. Whoa, what a finish. That's called hang time. Watch this. Dustin Scott, great defense from Michael Faye, but he holds it just long enough and completes the layup. Nice pass. John Smith Jr., you know, that's tough to finish when you're right under the basket and you have the human eraser standing over you, the league's leading shot blocker. You got to be really crafty down there to make any sort of layups. Nevertheless, draw a foul. So John Smith Jr., no foul there. Try to convince the refs that he was. Wow, quick release, and that's good. For Satoris. He's got a nice looking three-point shot. So again, Warriors so reliant on that three. Complete at that time. Arnold way open. Good. So that's his second shot from that baseline. You cannot give Yann Arnold that much room. Sloppy defense from the Warriors. Gotta close out on Arnold. Oh, Johnson gets his hands caught in the cookie jar. Here comes Williams, foul. Smart foul from John Smith Jr. It's a hard foul, but that's definitely the right foul. So you see, you know, really hits Williams hard on the arm, but no flagrant foul there in my opinion. That's just good, smart basketball. Wow, and they're gonna say that's excessive. And I don't think so. Of course, that's not my right arm being hit like that. If it was, I'd probably want a technical foul as well, but I think that's just a smart foul from John Smith, and I think the refs should call that just a normal foul. So Williams makes the Warriors pay on the technical. Williams already has 9 rebounds this game. So he's definitely going to get his double-double suit. Play. Wow, quick release from Avenido. Banks it in. Leo for 3-0. Did he mean to bank that one in? Who cares? That's 3 more points for the Saigon Heat. Johnson in the post, nowhere to go. Wow, wild left-handed circus shot. Gets his own rebound, and that's off the foot of Froy Baggion. So Warriors will luck out there and get a second chance. So Warriors with Gunawan, Dodo, Tremaine Johnson, Michael Fay, and John Smith Jr. in the game. Struggling on the offensive end with only 16 points after 15 minutes of action. Just over 1 point per minute for the Warriors. Smith Jr. loves the pick and roll, launches from way downtown, doesn't get a bank three of his own. Butler looking to post up Gunawan. Here comes the double team. He's trapped. Gets it to Lay, to Baggion. Back to Scott. Open for 3. No good. Oh, Williams had the offensive rebound but couldn't hold on to it. And either can Tremaine Johnson. What hustle from Dustin Scott, the Butler. Gets back on defense. You see Williams. Great defense from Dustin Scott. You gotta love that hustle from your starters. Warriors will get another chance, and Arnold is gonna look to check back in the game soon. So, the Kudu on Baggion. To Tepu. To Lakudu. High arcing 3. No good. So, Warriors are 2 for 10 from beyond the arc. They're gonna need to improve those percentages to stay in this game. Wow, Baggion getting all sorts of screens from his team. Avenido, whoa, didn't even draw iron. Oh, no look pass from Lakudu, intercepted. Warriors, another chance, no hesitation from Gunawan, and he misses his second try. And Heat are gonna slow down the pace here and look to get it into their bigs. 4 minutes left to go in the second period. Heat up by 12, back door. Avenido blows the layup, but gets the tip in. And that is one of the Saigon Heat's favorite plays. When Baggion comes down on the right side, he loves to go back door to either Arnold or Avenido. And that time, Avenido gets his putback. So if you're Coach Pokorda, you gotta warn your players to look out for that backdoor cut. So aside from the Warriors' 2 international imports, Fay and Johnson, who have 6 and 4 points respectively, the Warriors have only been able to put up six other points, three from John Smith and three from Citrus. They're 2-4-11 from downtown, and they're going to need to start knocking down some J's to keep this close. They're falling behind, now down by 14 against the home team Heat. That's a costly turnover from the Kudu. So crafty veteran defense from Baguio. That's not the play you want coming out of a timeout. So Coach Kokorda not happy with that effort. Now, I don't know what it is about the Heat versus the Warriors, but the Heat just seem to have the Warriors' number. Oh, great defense from Faye, making life difficult for Williams. Heat hang on to it. Avenido, floater, too strong. Here come the Warriors in the open court. Johnson, bounce pass was meant for Lakudu, but good recovery from Baguio. So who's gonna step up for the Warriors without Arki Wisnu and Vintan Nolent to the top scorers for the Warriors? Not here today. Smith asking for the pick, gets it. Fall away, jumper to the right. John Smith Jr., nice looking shot. So Heat really have to zone in on Johnson, Fay, and Smith, who are doing all of the offensive damage for the Warriors. Smith, in particular, loves that jumper going to the right. Williams open from the free throw line. Oh no. Second chance for the Heat. Avenido Hierarcher. Woo-hoo-hoo! He almost hit the top of the gym with that shot. That's ridiculous. That's just absolutely ridiculous. Look at the arc on that three-pointer. Money. Warriors score in a hurry and keep the lead to just 15. Look out for Avenido. If he has any space whatsoever, he's gonna launch. As does Baguio. Baguio has a nice shot, but is a pass-first point guard, likes to get his team involved. Whoa. Tough call there on Viet Arnold. That looked like good defense to me. But Tremaine Johnson, never afraid to take it to the hole. And we're gonna have a timeout. Coach Rabideau wants to talk things over with 1:50 left to go in the second period. You're watching ABL on the live stream. So if you're just joining us, the Indonesia Warriors continue to struggle against the Saigon Heat, down 18 to 33. And even though the Warriors have beaten High Tech Bangkok City, they've beaten the Slingers, they've beaten the Dragons, something about the Saigon Heat gives them a lot of problems. Leo Avenido. What a game he is having so far with 13 points and already 3 three-pointers. When Avenido is hot, the Heat are tough to stop. Heat ball. Tremaine Johnson, 1-for-10 from the field. And 0-for-3 from three-point land. So Tremaine Johnson
The Warriors' leading scorer, averaging 18 points a game, really struggling today. Arnold to Williams. Ooh, ball slipped out of his hand. He had a clear path to the basket. That's one of the few times you'll see Williams miss a shot like that. And the bunny is in the pea patch there. Travel for the Warriors. Costly, costly turnover. And let's see if the Warriors can break 20 points in this first half. Heat, although they're not shooting super well, just, you know, with their size, and Avenido's hot outside shooting, just dominating this game so far. Troy has to put it up. Wild shot. Another offensive rebound for Williams. And it will be Heat ball. So Warriors thought that was a shot clock violation, but Williams, another offensive rebound for him. And you know, Michael Fay has to box out Justin Williams. So Ryan Lay and Phan Tran Mun check in with a minute left. Two local players for the Saigon Heat. Give the Heat starters a blow. Arnold from downtown. Good. So watch this. Arnold in the face of Gunawan. Wow. Johnson strong to the hole. Reverse layup, no good. Satapu fouled. Oh, that's going to be Viet Arnold's second foul. And Dodo Satapu will go to the stripe. Satapu averaging 6 points and 3.3 rebounds per game. Satapu has played 12 games for the Warriors, one of their mainstays on this team. Dodo misses the first, drills the second. Looks like Coach Rabideau wants to give Avenido another three-point opportunity with 26 seconds left. So Baguion will hold the ball, and the Heat will try to get a good look here as the shot clock winds down. 9 seconds left. Avenido is going to go one-on-one against Satepu. 3 seconds left. Williams from the free throw line, short. 4 seconds left. Smith Jr. launches it from half court, almost makes it. So the Indonesia Warriors struggle on the offensive end and barely manage to put 20 points on the board. They're gonna have to bring out a whole new bag of tricks and a lot better shooting in the second half to make this a contest. So go get a drink, take a bathroom break, check out some of the other games on our YouTube channel, and we'll be right back in about 10 minutes. This is your commentator, Darren Joe from CIS Arena, Heat, with a commanding 16-point lead going into the second half. Thank you.
Indonesia Warriors với tỷ số là 36-20. Bây giờ chúng ta sẽ cùng gặp gỡ ông Jason Rabados, huấn luyện viên trưởng của đội bóng rổ Saigon Heat. Xin chào ông, xin ông hãy cho biết là ông nhận xét như thế nào về hai hiệp đấu vừa rồi. Các cầu thủ Saigon Heat có chơi đúng với những gì mà ông mong muốn hay không?
Hello, what do you think about the first two quarters? Did the player play up to your expectation?
One of the best basketball halves we've played this year. Our defense really good and we're really moving the basketball.
Đây là nửa hiệp đấu thành công nhất của Saigon Heat trong mùa này. Chúng tôi đã di chuyển rất nhiều và chúng tôi đã có những cú ném rổ thành công.
Now the message is, we gotta stay aggressive and finish.
Và bây giờ chúng tôi sẽ cần cố gắng giữ vững phong độ đó và thi đấu căng hơn nữa để có thể giành được chiến thắng.
Thưa ông, trong thời gian gần đây thì Saigon Heat liên tiếp nhận phải những trận thua ngược, mặc dù đã dẫn trước đội bạn trong hầu hết thời gian của trận đấu. Vậy trong trận đấu này chúng ta sẽ phải làm gì để không lặp lại tình huống đó một lần nữa?
In a few games recently, Saigon Heat lost in the last minutes although they were leading the score during the games. So what are you planning to do this game to avoid that?
We need to stay aggressive. You know, and our defense will be what wins it for us. But we really need to stay aggressive on offense and defensively.
Chúng tôi phải thi đấu vững chãi hơn nữa và sẽ luôn luôn với tinh thần là phòng thủ thật là chặt để có thể giành được chiến thắng ngày hôm nay.
Thank you very much. Và bây giờ chúng ta sẽ cùng gặp gỡ ông Sanjaya Wibawa, huấn luyện viên trưởng của đội Indonesia Warriors. Xin chào ông, xin ông hãy cho biết là ông nhận xét như thế nào về hai hiệp đấu vừa rồi. Cầu thủ nào của đội chủ nhà đã gây khó khăn nhiều nhất cho ông?
Hello, what do you think about the first two quarters? And did the home team give you a lot of difficulties?
Yes, they give us a lot of difficulty. We give up too many offensive rebounds and they take advantage of them. They make a point from second chance point. That's big. We gotta play defense on the second half.
Thực sự thì chúng tôi thi đấu phong độ không được tốt lắm trong hai hiệp vừa rồi. Chúng tôi đã làm lỡ rất là nhiều cái sự giành bóng dưới rổ. Cho nên là trong trận đấu thứ hai, hiệp đấu thứ ba này thì chúng tôi sẽ cố gắng hết sức để phòng thủ, đồng thời sẽ tấn công tốt hơn.
Thưa ông, trong thời gian gần đây thì Saigon Heat liên tiếp nhận phải những trận thua ngược, mặc dù đã dẫn điểm trong hầu hết thời gian của trận đấu. Vậy ông có tin rằng đội của mình sẽ một lần nữa làm được điều này trước Saigon Heat hay không?
In a few recent games, Saigon Heat lost in the last minutes although they were leading the score during the games. So, do you believe that you can change the situation like that and win over the Saigon Heat like other team did already?
If we start playing defense, we might. If we start playing defense, we might turn.
Nếu chúng tôi phòng thủ tốt hơn trong hai hiệp đấu còn lại thì có thể chúng tôi sẽ làm được điều đó.
Xin cảm ơn ông rất nhiều. Thank you very much. Thưa quý vị, còn bây giờ xin mời quý vị và các bạn chúng ta hãy cùng tiếp tục theo dõi hai hiệp đấu còn lại của trận đấu.
Right, so there you heard it from both coaches. Coach Jason Rabideau, the Saigon Heat,
wants his team to stay aggressive, and Coach Kokorda from the Warriors saying that his team needs to do a better job of controlling the glass and not giving the Heat second chance opportunities. So Coach Kokorda thinks that rebounding and defense are going to what will give his team a chance to win this game. This is your commentator, Darren Joe, coming at you live on the live stream. Go figure. Heat up 36-20 heading into the second period. And yes, the Heat have been winning the battle of the boards. In fact, they have out-rebounded the Warriors by 8, 30-22 in the first half. And more importantly, they've gotten 12 second chance points and 16 points in the paint compared to the Warriors' 8 points in the paint. Warriors also need to do a better job of protecting the ball, as the Heat have gotten 11 points off of turnovers from the Warriors. So not many positive signs so far for Indonesia. Justin Williams already has 11 rebounds, and 5 of those are offensive rebounds to go along with 7 points. And with Leo Avenido shooting the way he is, the Heat's marksman making 3 three-pointers already, and he has 13 points, and he's shooting 45% from the field. You know, the Warriors are going to really have to make their shots. Jermaine Johnson, the team's leading scorer, has struggled so far, making only 1 out of 11 attempts. And his teammates haven't done much better to help him. Michael Fay with an impressive 6 points and 10 rebounds, but otherwise, you know, little scoring from the Warriors. So Coach Kokorda electing to go with a different lineup to start this second period. John Smith Jr., Lakudu in the backcourt, and Sitepu Johnson and Fay in the frontcourt. John Smith Jr., you know, had 5 points in that first half and knocked down some jumpers. Let's see if he can continue that in the second half. So here we go. Warriors Heat on the live stream. Fay, left-handed jumper, good. So, let's see if the Warriors continue to pound it down to new international import Michael Fay and let him go to work. Play more of an inside-out game in this second half than outside-in. Baggion, 8 seconds on the shot clock from way downtown. Too strong. And that time, the Warriors box out and get the rebound. So no second chance there for the Heat, and a good start for the Warriors in the second period. Johnson for the baseline. No, so he can't buy a bucket in this game so far. Arnold, nice give and go. Splash! Uses the big screen from Dustin Scott. That's all the time in the world to knock it down. Two consecutive left-handed post moves from Fay. So he seems to be the focal point of the offense now, with Tremaine Johnson struggling. Warriors are going to keep pounding it into Fay. Scott in rhythm. Knocks it down. Get it into Fay again. Heat are not double teaming it. Fay, when he's in the post, they're just letting Williams guard him one-on-one. And Fay with 3 consecutive scores. So Coach Rabideau might consider doubling him down there. He's looking pretty unstoppable so far this period. Step back from Scott. Nice box out there from Fay. No second chances in this third period, unlike the first half, for the Saigon Heat. Warriors are sticking to their game plan. Back into Fay. He's in too deep. Blows the layup, and it's off his foot.
So another fantastic pass and look for Faye. Dodo Satepu, Christian Satepu checks in for John Smith Jr. Can the Heat hold on to their lead? They're up by 15. Scott, off balance jumper. Off the mark. Mukudu organizing the offense and again looking to pound it in to Faye. Johnson from the free throw line. This is another jump shot. Oh, Faye, too much space, wide open, in and out. So, the Warriors have two great looks to have possession. And if they can continue getting those sort of looks, Heat are in trouble. What a crossover from Bagion! And he does not finish, but he faked Lakudu out of his shoes. Goodness gracious, there was a top 10 crossover video for the ABL, that might be number one. Goodness gracious, let's see the replay on that one. So again, you can catch every AirAsia ASEAN Basketball League game on the live stream. Just go to YouTube/ABL and every game will be live there. You can also go to ASEANBasketballLeague.com and find a link to the live games on the homepage. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well with updates on all the games. Oh, that's some great interior passing from the Warriors. Faye can't get it over the mountain. That is Justin Williams. Watch this. One chance. Faye for a second chance. No. Too far under the rim, but good effort from Michael Faye. Lakudu, show and go. Rejected by the human eraser, Justin Williams. Better not come into the paint with that weak stuff against the league's leading shot blocker. Johnson, aggressive move, and he is just off rhythm this game. And I don't know why the Warriors aren't going back to Michael Faye in the post. He's absolutely dominating Williams so far in this third period. Ooh. Avenino, nice backdoor cut to Scott with the throwdown, and he hangs on the rim. Woo! JD Brothers in effect. Justin to Dustin with the wicked throwdown. Goodness gracious. Just throw it down, big man. Throw it down. Johnson with the easy putback, and Heat have to box out. Remember, one of the keys of the game, don't give the Warriors second chances. It's a recurring theme of this game for both teams. Ooh, and there's that backdoor cut that Bagion loves. Ooh, a little gamesmanship here between Vian Arnold and Sirigar. Sirigar has one of my favorite names. Oh, look at the two players going at each other. You know, that's fierce competition in the ABL. Like two battling rams. And the Sirigar just falls down. It looks like Vian Arnold breathed on him and he fell back. But Sirigar has one of my favorite names. Bonanza. Bonanza Christmas Sirigar. So testosterone running high on both squads after that exchange between Sirigar and Arnold. Things are heating up here at CIS Arena. The refs trying to manage the game, call foul. Michael Faye in his second game for the Indonesia Warriors. Proving that he is a solid big man, the 7-footer from UCLA. You know, the Warriors have gone through a lot of imports this year. You know,
They started with Christopher Barnes, and then Christian Ellis came in. O'Neal Mims and Justin Howard have all played a couple games for the Warriors, but now it is Michael Fay's turn. And he's doing a solid job this game. Whoa, dangerous pass there. Lay to Avenido, working in the post against the Taurus. Oh, Lay is open and finishes. Nice pass from Williams. Warriors weren't watching Lay, and he snuck back door for that nice finish. Lay, one of the top two reserves for the Saigon Heat. Wow. King Sirigar bricks from three. Arnold a little out of control. It'll be Heat ball. Indonesia Warriors shooting 21% from the field. Yikes. Saigon Heat still up by 15 with 3 minutes and 45 seconds left. Lay feeling confident after that layup. Too many players on one side of the court there. Williams, jump hook, short. Scott, what a finish. He somehow controlled that on his left hand, almost like he was spinning a pizza. Watch Justin Scott come in, somehow control that ball. And Coach Kokorda cannot be happy with that box out effort from his team. Great play, Justin Scott. Face pass picked off by Avenido. And Heat are on a run here, up 17. Looking to get it to 20. Nice bounce pass to Williams. What a finish. And Warriors falling apart in this third quarter. They were down by 16. And now they're down by 17. So, sorry, I'm not sure what the call was there. Not quite sure what the call was there. But the Heat are up by 17. Tapu for the top of the mountain. No good, and Warriors are really struggling with their shot this game. The Heat just seem to have their number. Like I mentioned earlier, the Heat have won their two previous meetings. So Warriors now going to a 2-3 zone, trying to mix it up on defense to stop this run. Wow, Bagion gives it a shot, no good. Let's see if the Warriors can narrow this lead to single digits by the end of this quarter. Sirigar's wide open. Way off on the three. Oh, Lakudu, nice look to Sirigar. An extra pass to Satepu. Smith, step back three, nails it. Wow, some good ball movement there from the Warriors, and that stops the bleeding momentarily. Scott, oh, wow. Turnover, but the Heat are really looking for that backdoor cut. So they're going high-low passing, and that has been the difference in this third period. Can the Heat stay in the playoff race with a very important win here over the Warriors? Can they hold on to this lead? Finally, Warriors go back into Fay. Gudawan. Wow, I mean, they are really off the mark on their shots. So Warriors struggling to get in rhythm. Whoa, Arnold's called for the... Wow, foul on John Smith Jr. I thought that Arnold got away with a walk there. It looked like he left his feet. Or it was just a fantastic pump fake. Either way, it's a third foul. I'm John Smith Jr. Nice box out there from Fay. Warriors. Nice pass from Faye, but Roni Gunawan, who has checked in, wasn't looking for it. So the two Gunawans are in for the Warriors. Williams bricks from the free throw line. It'll be Warriors ball. So another low scoring quarter for both teams. Heat have only put up 11 points. And Warriors have put up 13 points. So there's Coach Kokorda, and he's telling his team they need to box out and play great D. Well, they're playing better D this quarter, but their offense still struggling. Ooh, wild pass from Gunawan to Faye. Left hand, third chance, stripped, fouled. So Faye looks a little winded out there in his second game, getting his win, but his effort is there. And he is keeping his team in this game with his rebounding and post play. Faye has played all over the world. He's played in China, Poland, the UAE, Japan, and for the Lakers. His hometown after attending UCLA. So a 13-point lead, and the Heat will hold on for their last possession of the game. Baggio finds Avenido in the corner for three. Good! Leo for three. Whoa! And with that three-pointer, the Heat close out the quarter strong with a 16-point lead against the Warriors. Bagan finding his fellow Filipino in the corner, and that is too much room for the best three-point shooter in the ABL. Splash. Both teams score 14 points that quarter, so the Heat still up by 16 heading into the fourth. Joining us on the ABL live stream. You're watching the Heat versus the Warriors. I'm your commentator, Darren Joe, calling the game for you here on this beautiful Sunday night in Ho Chi Minh, Vietnam. Battle between the fourth and fifth place teams, and the Indonesian Warriors unable to find the answer against the Saigon Heat so far. They're being outscored in the paint 22-12. And despite the workmanlike effort of new international import Michael Faye, who has 15 points and 19 rebounds, no other player for the Warriors has double digits in scoring. So it's been all Michael Faye for the Warriors. And that's not going to be enough against the Heat. And Dustin Scott, who now has That's 15 points. Justin Scott with a fantastic move and a fantastic game so far. A quick turnover to start the fourth period, and things are not looking good for the Warriors. Coach Rabideau exhorting his Heat to stay aggressive and close out this game. Avenido is going to be called for the ticky-tack foul, sticking out his bottom on that screen. And referees have really enjoyed calling fouls on Leo, especially offensive fouls, a lot of them in the past few games. The fourth game of a four-game homestand for the Heat. They want to finish it up with a victory. Warriors looking to go back down to Faye. Oh man, Maine Johnson's gotta finish that. He's one of the best scorers in the league, and he had a bunny there, and he was way off the mark. With that miss, Jermaine Johnson is 2 for 16 this game. Nice box out there, an outlet pass to Smith Jr. all the way with a floating left-handed reverse layup. Beautiful transition play. Tremaine Johnson to Smith, and that's one of their very few fast break points. In fact, I believe that's their first two fast break points of the game. So Heat have done a good job of getting back on defense. With a few substitutions on the floor. In for the Warriors is Sirigar for Gunawan. Gunawan had a few great games shooting the three, hasn't been on the mark this game, and either has Sirigar. Heat Warriors in a 2-3 defense. Trying to slow down this Heat offense. Scott in rhythm, good, and he is confident. And when Dustin Scott is shooting the ball like that, man, he is one of the best players in the league. Two-man game, Johnson and Faye. Faye in too deep, but the two big men not coordinating on that pass. So the Warriors' woes on offense continue. And if the Heat can stay disciplined, looks like they have this game. Wow. Williams amongst the trees finishes. Wow. Double team there by both Faye and Johnson. It still elevates enough to get it in. And Faye is fouled there by Williams. So nice sequence of moves from Faye. And if the Warriors can move the ball and get a great inbounds pass to Faye, man, he is tough to stop down there. He's big, he's crafty, he's got a nice touch. Sure, Coach Kokorda is liking what he's seeing from big man Michael Fay. Warrior Nation sure is as well, I am sure. Heat starting lineup, who are still in the game in the fourth quarter, same starting lineup. They average over 35 minutes a game, so they barely get any rest. And it's been a problem in the past couple games, closing out tight games against top teams. But it looks like they have this one under control. Commentator's curse, as I say that, careless pass from Avenido, and here come the Warriors. Setepu's open on the weak side. Smith couldn't find him. And again, wow, nice high-low idea from the Warriors. Just someone got a hand in there, but that's the right idea. Pound it into Faye. Let him go to work and slow down the pace of this game. Faye, left-handed jump hook, too strong. So way off the mark that time for Michael Fay. Kokorda coach. Things getting testy here. So Smith Jr. will inbound the ball. And John Smith Jr. saying it was his fault that time on the turnover. He wasn't looking for the pass back from Sitepu. Smith putting some full court press on Viet Arnold, who is a very confident ball handler. And the Heat are slow to set up their offense. They gotta stay aggressive here. That's a turnover from Froy. Williams, ball is flying all over the place. Somehow gets his hand on it and will give his team a second chance. So the next game for these two teams, Saigon Heat playing Laskar Drea, South Sumatra, 7 p.m. in Batam. So Heat have won all three of their games against Laskar Drea. You can catch that game on the live stream September 26th. And if you're an Indonesia Warriors fan, their next game is the 28th against the Singapore Slingers. And that's at 4 p.m. at Brit Am Arena. Ugly fast break from the Warriors. Smith tries to make up for it with a three. Wow. And despite a great effort from Viet Arnold to corral the rebound, we're gonna give him a foul there. That's his third. So Warriors get a second chance, but they're down by 18 points in this fourth quarter. And they've only managed to put up 38 points in the entire game. So without Arki Wisnu and Vinton Noland, Warriors struggling on offense, but that's a beautiful turnaround shot from Roni Gunawan. Wow, nice touch there from Gunawan. Might be a little too late though, with 5 minutes and 50 seconds left to go. This has been all Heat so far. Magyan trying to thread the double team, and he's had a few sloppy plays in the past few possessions. And speaking of sloppy, Michael Fay's hands either have too much sweat or too much rock or just couldn't hold on to the ball. So I think Michael Fay is really tired after putting in an outstanding effort this game, playing every minute for the Warriors. His team down by 16. You're watching the live stream. Justin Williams has absolutely abused the Warriors on the boards. Coming into this game, he's averaged 20 rebounds a game. This game, he might just get there. He has 16 rebounds, so the Warriors have been unable to keep him off the glass. Oh, Avenido's open in the corner. A little too strong. Scott fakes John Smith Jr. Nice follow from the butler. And that play encapsulates what the butler can do. He can pass, he can rebound, he can shoot, he can finish. Whatever you need, he serves you up. Oh, nice pass, Gunawan. Sitepu, Faye. That's some beautiful interior passing from the Warriors. It's too bad that has come with under 5 minutes left to go in this game. Warriors in the 2-3 zone. Oh man, Baggion. Arnold takes it the distance and scores on the 7-footer. Two Americans going at it. Watch Vian Arnold really use his body to create just enough space to get that ball in. John Smith Jr. doesn't even draw iron on that shot. Wow. And you can just see it in the Warriors' faces. They just don't have an answer against the Saigon Heat. The curse of the Heat for the Warriors. It's just too easy. Vian Arnold runs the baseline as if no one's guarding him. And Williams is just too tall underneath. Nice pass there, Smith Jr. to Fay. Warriors connecting. So they've had a few easy layups, but it's just too late. So with this win, much needed win, the Saigon Heat will move to 6-7, and the Warriors will fall to 6-9, which means that the Heat will now be in fourth place, and wow, they need to be in the top four to make the playoffs. So a big win for the Saigon Heat this Sunday. Scott open for three, no. And Smith hangs on to the rebound. Just trying to get some momentum. Sirgar's open, great looking shot, splash. Sirgar has just a really clean release. Reminds me of Ray Allen, but he's only made one of four attempts this game. Wow, Arnold splits the double team, double dribble, turnover. And even with the Heat, with a comfortable lead, the Saigon Heat Boo Birds come out in full force. You gotta love the Saigon Heat crowd. Don't just watch the game on the live stream. If you're living in Vietnam, come out to a game. And the atmosphere here is great, CIS Arena. Always loud and involved is the Saigon Heat crowd. Wow, and one, and finally, Tremaine Johnson is rewarded for his aggressiveness. He has really struggled this game. Shooting 2-for-15 from the field, Tremaine Johnson. Completes the three-point play, and he gets into double digits on the scoreboard. The Heat trying to beat this press, do slow it down, trying to take some time off the clock, but it's a turnover. Johnson to Rony Gunawan, nice reverse layup finish. Whoa, and it's a 10-point game with 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Did I put this in the refrigerator too early? Is it the curse for the Saigon Heat this season is not being able to close out games? They're up by 10. Nice backdoor cut, Williams throws it down and puts Gunawan on a poster. Good gracious. Good God. I just saw a man fly again. And Williams, no mercy on local player Rony Gunawan. Welcomes him to the ABL League. Watch this. Elevates and throws it down on his head. Wicked. So Justin Williams puts the exclamation mark on this game, giving his team a comfortable 12-point cushion. 2 minutes left. So who are your favorite teams to watch in the AirAsia ABL? Is it high-tech Bangkok City with their twin towers, the Dragons with their explosive wings, or the Saigon Heat with their starting five. It's been a wide-open season this year, with the exception of Laskar Drea, South Sumatra, who have yet to score a victory and are now 0-13. Without a Filipino team in the AirAsia ABL this season, it's been high-tech Bangkok City and the Westport Malaysia Dragons jostling for the number one spot. Both teams playing great this season. But the Saigon Heat, even though they're currently in fifth place, have been up against all four teams above them. And if the Saigon Heat can make the playoffs, I believe they have as good of a shot as any of winning. The issue is, can they do it with this Indonesia Warriors team and a resurgent Slingers team? Wow, Johnson with an air ball on the three. Ugly stuff. Here comes Viet Arnold, coast to coast. Almost like he's playing hockey out there. Heat playing keep away, trying to run out the clock and finish this homestand with a 2-2 record. Arnold with the dagger. Look at that. Great release in rhythm from Arnold. Oh, no one boxes out Michael Fay. That's just too easy for the big man. Heat beating the press. Williams with a little touch shot and knocked out of bounds by Viet Arnold. So as I mentioned earlier on the broadcast, the Heat have a tough schedule ahead of them. Their next game is against Laskar Drea. They'll look to win that one easily. But after that, they face high-tech Bangkok City twice, the Slingers twice, the Dragons once, and this Indonesia Warriors team at Brit Ama Arena. So they have a really tough schedule ahead of them. And at least they can end this four-game homestand with some momentum. We have some foul play here. Words spoken and emotions broiling between Sirigar and Bagyan. And so Sirigar, let's see what happens here. Maybe a little too aggressive on that foul. Bagyan didn't like that. And he'll head to the free throw line. So the magician. So far this game hasn't made a field goal. It's 0-for-6. But has 3 assists to go along with 3 turnovers. So Froy not having his best game. But finally gets on the scoreboard with that free throw. Oh my goodness. I don't know what happened there. Froy with an air ball on the free throw. You never see that from him. Froy is an 80% free throw shooter, so maybe just a little tired. Williams is gonna try a three in and out. So Williams having some fun here to close out this game. Avan Saputra has checked in and doesn't finish that fast break. But Johnson does add one. So Heat a little sloppy here in the last couple minutes, but I think they're just relieved to get a victory. And it's been a tough homestand for the Heat. They've been up against the Dragons and lost that game. They've been up against the Slingers before Wong Wei Long turned all Singapore Mamba on the Heat with some clutch shots, and he led his team to victory here. So the Heat have had some tough losses at home, but this time they're going to walk away with the victory. And the Heat have to make sure they advance with 8 seconds and get it into that front court. The Heat are going to run out the clock. 7 seconds remaining. Arnold's going to give it to Scott, who launches the three. Too strong. So, Warriors. Smith hits the three to give his team 61 points, but that score is misleading because it's been all Saigon Heat this game. Oh, and Williams hits the three-pointer. Goodness gracious, nothing but net. And that's symbolic of this game. Everything going the Saigon Heat's way. Justin Williams. Wow. Finish it. So there's been not one MVP for the Saigon Heat. Their starting five were excellent this game. Justin Williams dominating the boards. And Dustin Scott, Leo Abenito, and David Arnold all scoring in double figures and all shooting higher than 45%. So a relieved Saigon Heat crowd and a relieved Saigon Heat team with the victory, 72-61 over a depleted Warriors team. So Heat with the victory, stay in fourth place. Thank you.